Very good afternoon to you, sir. Good afternoon, ma'am. A very good afternoon to all of you, sir.
Thank you. So, let's see. Are you reading newspapers?
Yes.
You are? You must be aware of important events which are taking place or have taken place, say, in the last 6-7 days.
Yes, sir.
Right? Can you identify some of those events in the national field or international field?
Sir, one of the most important event is the conflict between CBI and the West Bengal government, which has erupted
just now. But there are much more important issues than that. This is a temporary thing. It's not so of a great national importance. Talk of national, things of national importance.
Sir, the budget...
It's only a political thing. It has so much importance.
Sir, the budget which has come
budget.
On...
So, February, budget is one, alright. Budget is one. What else?
Sir, the government has notified the 10% quota for economically weaker sections.
Alright. And what is the significance of it now? There is a matter pending.
Sir, the matter is pending before the Supreme Court.
Therefore, it becomes important. The Supreme Court has to give a constitutional interpretation.
Yes, sir.
Or, good. Or what else?
Sir, the NRC issue is also pending
NRC,
before the Supreme
NRC.
Court.
What is the latest about NRC? What has Supreme Court said?
Sir, the Supreme Court has scolded the government saying that the government is not able to complete the NRC by the deadline of 31st July 2018.
Very good. This is all right. Anything else you can think of which are before the Supreme Court? Mind you, these are all matters of current interest also, current affairs. Eh? Anything important which is coming before the Supreme Court? Lokpal?
Yes, sir.
Lokpal?
Sir, the appointment of Lokpal has been delayed and...
What is the Supreme Court's latest directive?
Sir, the Supreme Court has directed the government to appoint the Lokpal as soon as possible.
As soon as possible? But it is given a deadline.
I'm sorry, sir.
No. Alright.
Mr. Jain, in the last couple of months, a large number of people have been arrested by the NIA in India who had been radicalized and were supporting the ISIS. Very briefly, can you tell me what is the ISIS all about, their ideology, their leadership?
Sir, ISIS emerged as a revolting movement against Syrian dictatorship, and its aim is to establish an Islamic caliphate throughout the world.
Okay. And who is the leader of this group?
Sir, I'm not sure. I think it's Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi.
Al-Baghdadi, that's right. Now, they have been following a very unique system of recruitment, unlike others. What is this system? What is their primary source of recruitment?
Sir, one of their most primary source of recruitment is online.
Online, that's right. Online, they have been recruiting, and so it's happened in India also, that a large number of these people have been radicalized. Now, do you think that the ISIS is a threat to India?
Yes,
or
sir.
Could pose a threat?
Yes, sir.
In what way?
Sir, firstly, it can cause terrorist attacks in India through its handlers in India. Secondly, it can cause communal divide between our communities by radicalizing the people. Thirdly, it is also exploiting the Jammu and Kashmir issue.
They talk of lone wolf attacks. That is one of their methods of terror. What does it mean, lone wolf attacks?
Sir, in lone wolf attacks, a single person who usually has been radicalized online does an attack like ramming a bus over people or attacking via knives or a gun shootout.
That's right. What was the last such terror attack in anywhere in Europe or America?
Sir, I remember Berlin attack. After
Berlin,
that,
yeah, and you're right. Okay, right. Now, you know, there is a project called Project Sagarmala. Have you heard of that?
Yes, sir.
What is that?
Sir, Sagarmala aims to leverage our blue economy by constructing several ports across India. Along with the ports, there will be construction of coastal economic zones so that export-oriented FDI can be brought there. And
right, good. You know, in the wake of the Mumbai attack in 2008, the government had created certain organizations. One is the NIA, and the other is the NatGrid. Are you aware of these organizations? What do they do?
So NIA investigates terrorist attacks and security issues.
Mm-hmm.
So NatGrid is an online mechanism which will collect information from several central agencies and collate it so that the suspected terrorists can be surveyed and terrorist attacks can be foiled beforehand.
Then what was the NCTC? What is the difference between NCTC and NatGrid then? NCTC did not come about. Why?
Yes, sir.
That NCTC, what is the full form of NCTC?
National Counter-Terrorism
Center. That was the organization to collate intelligence, which did not come about because of issues of federalism. States opposed it. NatGrid is basically the data which resides in various silos differently. Say the railways reservation data, airlines data, immigration data, income tax, tax credits, use of credit cards, all that is connected and it is available to individual intelligence agencies. That is NatGrid. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
So that is the thing. Okay, one more question. On this issue of Rohingyas, what is your stand? Do you think that we should allow them to be to stay in India or not?
So my stand is that we should not allow Rohingyas to stay in our country, because it poses a national security risk to us as reported by the IB. But in the meantime, until they are deported, we should also ensure that their human rights and dignity are ensured.
Thank you.
Can you tell us what are the legal and constitutional issues involved in this 10% reservation to economically weaker sections, which has been challenged also?
So the main legal issue arises from the Indira Soni judgment of 1992, which caps the reservation at 50%. Secondly, it has been challenged that reservation as a concept was meant for representation to the socially and economically, educationally backward, but this criteria does not take that into account.
Okay. Did we have reservation for socially and educationally backward classes in our constitution since the beginning, or did we insert it through an amendment in Article 15?
Sir, I just know that we had reservation for SCs and STs from the beginning. The OBC reservation was in the 1992.
Okay, can you tell us about what happened in, what was the judgment in Delhi government versus the LG case, which was reported widely in the media?
Yes, sir. So the Supreme Court clearly demarcated the powers between center and Delhi. It said that except land, law and order and police, all the matters will come under the jurisdiction of the Delhi government. Secondly, the lieutenant governor is bound by the aid and advice of the government of Delhi. Thirdly, in case of any conflict, the resolution has to go to the president of India. It further suggested both the governments to work in harmony, because it said that absolutism as well as anarchy cannot work in a democracy.
Okay. Can you tell us about some of the orders by NGT with regard to pollution in Delhi?
So one order was that it banned petroleum coke in Delhi. Secondly, it imposed a fine on Delhi government for failing to curb pollution.
Anything to do with construction? Okay. Now, can you tell us about, there was a judgment recently on insolvency and bankruptcy code. What was it?
Sir, the Supreme Court has upheld the validity of insolvency and bankruptcy code 2016, saying that it helps India to transition from a defaulter's paradise to a place where defaulters face deterrence.
What was challenged in that case?
So the one thing that was challenged was the order of payment of the creditors. So it said that the financial creditors will be paid before operational credit.
Okay, last what is diplomatic protection?
I beg your pardon,
diplomatic
sir?
Protection.
Sir, I'm not sure about it, but I think that under Vienna Convention, I think the diplomats get immunity from arrest and retention.
That is diplomatic immunity. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
You were a member of the NSS and you also worked in the health wing. So what did you do in this health wing?
Ma'am, as a volunteer, I was blood donation camps in association with Red Cross. Then we ran certain campaigns like Chuppi Todo Baithak to promote the issue of sanitary napkins for women. Then we did a campaign like We Scare Because We Care on Halloween to spread awareness regarding the ill effects of drugs and alcohol.
So when you did this blood donation camp, you also had girls in your college?
Yes, ma'am.
So what did you find regarding blood donations? Were they anemic or were they okay?
Ma'am, I was not there on the ground. Actually, I was part of the marketing team. So my aim was to collect and spread awareness and to collect as many people as we can. We saw that a lot of girls did donate blood.
Alright. Now, recently there was a study by an international center on receding glaciers in the Himalaya Hindu Kush. So how is it going to impact all of us?
Ma'am, firstly, receding of glaciers will directly impact the water availability and it may create a water crisis. Secondly, it will lead to further global warming and climate change, which may also affect the food security of India. The rising heat waves that the climate change will generate may also have health impacts on us. Like
so what is climate change? You're again and again talking about climate change. What is it? Is it only global warming?
And climate change basically refers to the long-term transition or change in the climate, particularly due to anthropogenic reasons. One of the main thing that we have observed in climate change is global warming.
So is anything being done on the international scene to look at climate change?
Yes, ma'am.
Have we had any international conferences?
Yes, ma'am. We have signed recently the Paris Climate Change Agreement under the UNFCCC. It provides that all the countries should voluntarily give their commitments to reduce their emissions.
So how will they reduce their emissions?
Countries have given commitments like reducing emissions by incorporation of solar power, using negative emissions through afforestation, promoting alternative fuels like biofuels.
What is carbon sinks?
Carbon sinks refer to trees or forests which help in reducing the carbon dioxide by absorbing them.
Alright. Now another topic, because you already talked about pollution, we have a program known as the Namami Gange.
Yes.
Can you tell me what the components of Namami Gange are and what exactly is this scheme?
And the Namami Gange scheme aims to clean Ganga. I am not sure of the exact components, ma'am, but it aims to prevent the sewage which is going into Ganga.
So how would we do that?
Ma'am,
by constructing?
Ma'am, by constructing sewage treatment plants.
Yes.
Secondly, we have linked it to Swachh Bharat Abhiyan.
Yes.
So the open defecation on the banks of River Ganga has been prevented.
Mm-hmm.
The direct industrial waste which used to go into Ganga has also been regulated.
Yes, and we also have a task force to maintain the ghats and behavioral change. That's one of the common components of both Swachh Bharat and Namami Gange.
Yes, sir.
Have you heard of the interlinking of rivers scheme?
Yes,
what is this project?
When the interlinking of rivers aims to resolve the irrigation issue as well as drinking water issue by creating canals between two rivers.
So will there be any environmental factors which will impact all of us?
Yes, ma'am. There are certain environmental concerns, like it will affect the natural flow of river.
Yes.
It will lead to diversion of forest land and impact wildlife habitat. And thirdly, it may impact the aquatic life in the rivers, which may not be able to migrate and reproduce.
Okay. Thank you.
Mr. Abhishek, the interim budget was presented on 1st of this month. There are apprehensions that some of the proposals might result in enhancing the fiscal stress. You agree on that?
Yes, sir. So the government has said that due to the existing schemes, our fiscal deficit will be at 3.4% in this year as well as the next financial year.
Which are the proposals which might add to the fiscal stress?
So one is the Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi, which aims to provide direct income-based support to our farmers. Secondly, Pradhan Mantri Shram Yogi Manthan, which aims to provide pension support, and thirdly, the relief and the relaxation in our taxation structure.
Okay. Apart from the impact on the fiscal situation, there might be also implementation issues. What kind of implementation problems be there in some of these schemes? I don't refer to the direct tax proposal, but that is basically an ongoing thing. But the other two schemes, there might be implementation problems.
Yes, sir. Sir, one of the most important problem will be of inclusion and exclusion errors, wherein the real beneficiaries may not be able to get the direct support. Secondly, regarding the direct income support, the limit is less than 2 hectares. So it might lead to people fragmenting their land and diverting them on different accounts so as to receive the income, which will lead to income support to even the large farmers. Thirdly, it is very difficult to take up the informal workers in the formal economy, and it will be difficult to reach out to them and have their pension accounts opened.
Okay. What is the trend of tax collections in the current year?
Sir, as per the interim budget, the direct tax collections are going to be around 12 lakh crore rupees. There has been an 80% increase in the tax base. Regarding GST, the average monthly collections are around 97,100 crore rupees.
But are we likely to reach the target for tax collections, both direct and indirect?
Sir,
what is the budget? Are you revised estimates?
I'm not sure.
You are not sure. Okay. Angel tax, that is in the news. What exactly is an angel tax and why it is in the news?
So angel tax is a tax on the excess capital raised by the startups in case the income tax department believes that the share price was much more than the fair market value. It has recently been in news because several startups have received notices under the angel tax, and they are saying that it will impact their capital raising ability.
Was this provision utilized by some of the investors?
Yes, sir. Sir, the startups, many a times, income tax department says that the startups are in the form of shell companies.
Right.
So it is used for money laundering.
Yeah, last question. Your cutoff reference is Rajasthan. Rajasthan has made good progress in labor law reforms. Have you heard of that? What kind of reforms have been done in field of labor?
So one thing is that the Minimum Wages Act has been implemented for even the domestic workers and the maids.
That's not a big reform. Any other more structural reforms which has impact on the economy?
I'm sorry.
Industrial Disputes Act has been amended. Trade Unions Act has been amended. Contract Labour Act. Factories Act.
Okay, thank you.
Rajasthan? You're from Rajasthan?
No, sir.
Ah.
I'm from Delhi.
You talked of carbon sinks, etc. What are India's NDCs which it has conveyed to UNFCCC?
Sir, one is that we will reduce our carbon emissions by 33% of the 2005-06 levels. Secondly, we will create additional...
By which date? By which year?
I am not sure, sir.
2030. That is the cutoff date, 2030. Second?
So one is that we will create additional carbon sinks in our country.
Equivalent to what?
I am sorry, sir. I am not aware of the details.
2.5 billion tons to 3 billion tons of carbon dioxide.
Thank you, sir.
What else? By doing what?
So by afforestation.
By afforestation. What else? Third?
Sorry.
No? We will increase our share of renewable energy in power generation by 40%. By 40%. By 2030.
Yes.
Right. Now you've done commerce and etc. CSR, is it legally binding?
Yes, sir. Sir,
how do you say it is legally bound?
Sir, under the Companies Act 2013, the companies which have a turnover of more than 500 crore
they
or net profit of more than 50 crore, they are.
Or there are three.
Yes, sir. So the third
one. Alright, you check up on this. They have to shell out 2%.
2% of their average net profits of the last 3 years.
Yes. Now, I think profit is of how much? 5 crores. How much?
5 crores.
I think it is 5 crores. Now, is there a punishment for not doing it?
I'm sorry, sir. There might be a punishment, I think.
You haven't read?
No, sir. No.
Has the introduction of the new company law improved corporate governance?
Yes, sir. Sir, it has significantly improved corporate governance because, firstly, it has very strict provisions regarding.
Don't give general. Tell me in what way it has improved. There are more frauds. Frauds haven't stopped. Malia and Choksi and everyone. Banks are committing frauds. There is an improvement. I don't see. All right, how many people have been punished? Big sharks. Tell me.
Sir, A Raja has been punished.
A Raja is an old thing before this. A Raja is Satyam. Satyam happened before 2013. Don't name A Raja in this.
Yes, sir. I'm not aware.
There is no. Where is the punishment? Tell me. Tell me one single man who has only been put into jail. Only Supreme Court keeps twisting the tail of Mr. that.
UP.
Nahin pocho, Bengali hai.
Subroto Roy.
Subroto Roy. He's the only one. No. You must have specific information. Where is he? Oh, we have been. Where have you? It's totally. Choksi has run away, his uncle has run away, Malia has run away. Nothing. What happened to that? Those Cayman Island, those there were scandals which came out 2 years ago in which Amitabh Bachchan also had.
Paradise Papers.
Yes, nothing is heard of. So, where is it improved now? Think of it before you say it has improved a lot.
Okay.
Alright. So, we close the interview here. Now, I am giving you feedback. First is, you have improved a lot since we last, we asked you a lot of questions last time, but this time we asked you different questions.
Yes, sir.
On different issues. So prepare yourself, even if you prepare all these questions, I think you will have about 30-40 good questions which we have asked, which have a bearing on your biodata, on constitutional issues, current affairs, financial situation, accountancy, etc. तो इस पर ही आप बहुत तैयारी कर लीजिए उसी से ही आपको बहुत मदद मिल जाएगी जो हमने सवाल पूछे हैं
यस सर
अच्छा देन वी डिडंट आस्क यू ऑन सम इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग लाइक बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर कॉन्सेप्ट क्या है और आवर पॉलिटी इज फेडरल और यूनिटरी रिजिड और रिजिड एंड फ्लेक्सिबल बोथ ऑल दीस थिंग्स यू शुड चेक अप ऑन दिस Then check up some important like India's budget.
Yes, sir.
It will give you a lot of help. About this punishment for CSR violation, read Article 340, 450. No, not 340, 134. 134, 450, 451. I think there's a provision for punishment. It all says that there can be a 1 month imprisonment also, but I'm not sure. But at least fine is there. Government of India has already issued a notice to more than 1,000 companies for violation of.
Okay. Sir, regarding the Companies Act question, whether it has been successful, sir, how should I approach this question?
You should only see how many frauds were taking place earlier and after this. And then what has been the conviction rate?
So if the conviction rate is low, can I say that it
you,
has
you say low? That that cases have been registered but conviction is still low. So but you say that frauds are still taking place, which is a matter of concern.
Yes, sir.
Which is a fact, it is taking place.
Sir, in some questions, I tend to take a pause and then speak.
That's
is it fine, sir?
Absolutely. There's no problem. In fact, you should take a pause if you can't find an answer immediately. You should pause, and if you want, you can ask the board, may I take a few seconds? There's
okay,
no
sir.
Harm.
Thank you, sir.
It is not a rapid fire, you know, exchange. It is your ability to analyze nicely. That is what it will be, just. Okay. But.
Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.